Today's video is brought to you by Scentbird.
I don't know if I'm more afraid of meeting 20 people or being in front of cameras. I don't know which one's worse.
The teen edition.
I guess they're all like teenagers, like 19. To...
Oh, this is going to be nice.
You don't like teenagers and their dating life problems?
No.
Why not?
They don't have problems. I'm just kidding. That's not true.
I digress.
I'm kidding.
Remember, getting rejected at 18.
End
of the world.
I'm not serious.
I'd see a pimple on my face. And I'm like, oh, bitch. They discovered a new planet.
I'm not serious.
I'd be looking at my forehead like, oh, my God. Why is it so shiny? Jesus, you start making up problems.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. I know. You got problems. I know.
One time I looked in the mirror, I'm like, my nose crooked. And I was like, oh, fuck, they can all tell.
But that's because they broke your face, no?
Yeah. My nose is crooked. But as a 31-year-old, you're like, as a 31-year-old, you don't have...
It's character. But as a 19, like...
It's not that. As a 31-year-old, I'm like, girls already fucked me. It's okay. They already accepted my nose. It's okay. When you're 18 and you ain't got your dick wet before... Everything seems like a bigger problem, right? Ask all the virgins at home right now. They're just being like, right?
But yeah, you make
sense. Once you get over that hump, you start to realize your defects. Like, yo, somebody f*** me. Somebody else going to f*** me too.
Once you get over that hump, you get more humps.
Yeah, once you get over that hump, you start humping.
Oh, the more they add up, I can feel he's not comfortable with this. Oh, I feel this dude. Oh, poor dude.
Yeah. It's one of those things where sometimes you're so self-conscious that when someone does so interest, you're like, I don't believe you.
Yeah.
You're cute. Fuck you.
Shut up.
Fuck you.
You're just...
Well, excuse me? Yeah, fuck you, bitch.
But that's when you've been
bullying. You're trying to, try to raise me up so you can shit on me? Fuck you, whore. Nobody thinks I'm beautiful. She didn't do anything. The woman was perfectly nice.
Yeah.
And later on, you're like, why does anybody notice me?
Yo, you know, but you have a shit attitude. Just like that girl. Oh, he probably likes white women.
I've had this happen. A girl said, yo, Abba, what are you doing later on today? And I just went.
She was not even probably not interested.
I just forgot how to speak. I was like, she's talking to the nigga behind me. The locker.
You? Why are you asking me?
Yeah.
You're not supposed to ask me.
When you got that like anxiety and you don't have no confidence,
yeah
you'll sabotage.
It's.
Yeah. Acts of service? This nigga doesn't like acts of service? That's crazy. Acts of service are my favorite.
Of course it is.
You know. Why? What's that mean?
No, because I know.
What do you know?
What do I know?
Yeah. You looking at me with that fucking... This is the face he's giving me, okay? I watch out. This is the face.
Oh, I know. What was that? That means I know. Yo, can you do me a solid? That's you! That's you! You love that shit! That's you! That's you! More dramatic than it is, man. For no reason.
Because the people at home were like, that's him, nigga! That's him!
Say it with me now! That's you know right now!
Hey, nigga, do me a favor?
Right now,
acts of service!
Now point to the camera and say it with me now. That's you!
My thing is, I appreciate it. I appreciate it when people just do things for me, and I enjoy doing things for people, whether it be making them food, whether it be showing up to events, whether it be, you know, delivering things to them when they forgot at home. Little things like that that show you have the other person's back, I think are very nice. Yeah. So I think acts of service, me potentially, I think is one of my favorite things, because I think actions always speak louder than words. Personally, what are your thoughts?
I already said my thoughts. That's you, nigga!
There's nothing better than saying something sweet and then preach comes in with
All right, let's keep going. All right.
Today's sponsor is Scentbird. Now, I don't know if you're like me, but I am not too savvy when it comes to the world of scented perfumes and colognes. I just buy what works for me, and I stick with that. Basic? Yes. Does it work? Yes. But can you upgrade? You certainly can, and I think this is where Scentbird comes in. What's really cool about this subscription-based service, it allows you to try new fragrance every single month. They come in these really cool cylinders that are super easy to use. You just pop it up here, boom, that's it. Super easy to use, okay? And you can use it for 30 days, try it out, and if you like it, then you can commit. Rather than paying hundreds of dollars for a fragrance that you may not even like long term, this gives you a chance to actually rock it, wear it, see how you feel with it, whether it really jives with your own pheromones. And if you think it does, then you can commit. Or you can just switch to the next one and find out what else is in season right then and there. The same way your wardrobe changes as the season comes, so can your scents. You guys can try all of these yourselves. And they have high-end brands like Prada, Gucci, Versace, as well as a variety of high-end fragrances that you can choose from. All right, you can't just be out here looking good. If you don't smell good, trust me, folks are gonna notice. All right, all you people out here with some stinky armpits, not knowing how to use some perfume or some cologne, please do it. And I'm gonna help you. Make sure to use my coupon code and you get 30% off your first month. But again, it's time for you to upgrade, not just in other aspects of your life, but also your smell.
It's almost as if it's only about you. Just teenagers, right? They don't have to worry about anything else. They don't have to worry about no bills. But then at the same time, they have things like parents involved. There's school going on still. So it's like interesting.
Can we all appreciate how much confidence women take selfies? It's like, I know dudes in their 30s who still can't take a proper picture. Women are 15 being like...
No.
Sorry.
You went from under. That's contre-plongée. It makes you fat. It's always from above.
From above.
Always from above.
MySpace angles. My apologies. See, that's how I'm 31. I still don't know. But women,
if you work in TV with enough women, you know that they hate contre-plongée. When the camera goes down, it's like, really this shit again?
Yeah.
It's not gonna make my shit look fat.
Yeah.
They don't like that shit.
Look at the picture right there, right from above.
It's all gonna be from above. It's all from above.
Yeah.
Because I'm attracted to you because you shit and I'm a fly. And you, I think you pretty fly.
In high school, that would have passed.
Yeah, in high school.
If anyone is not interested on going on a date with women, please leave a message.
Damn, why? And he's getting stressed out. Like,
yeah, there's no right.
He's lying.
Bro. There's no good answer for this to go well for him. Hmm. Like, to make him feel better.
Yeah.
If they leave,
it's
not going to make him feel better.
Yeah.
If they don't leave, it's not going to make him feel better.
Yeah.
So as for physical attributes, I usually, you know, prefer someone that is shorter than me. But I'm 5'9". If I strap on some basketball shoes, maybe I'm 5'10".
He basically told him, if you're over 5'6", you got to go. You know why? Insecurity. He's not going to feel like he can be comfortable in it. I guess it's one of them power dynamics type of things.
Yeah.
But yeah, you know, the same way, like, there's some girls are like not above 6 feet, not below 6 feet. Some dudes will be like not above 5'5".
What's your not above?
Oh, I don't give a shit. Oh, yeah, you could be an Amazonian bitch. Yeah, I like getting on my toes to kiss a girl.
Yeah, I could be like that. Let me go get a stool.
Yeah.
I don't care.
Yeah, I said, come on, you're a big bitch.
Yeah.
I don't give a fuck.
Ooh, you a big bitch.
Yeah.
I wasn't his thing.
Yeah, I've done that. It's a weird feeling to be like, to grab the girl's hand and to look up.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've done that. I don't mind.
Yo, you know, I was in the States. The States is different.
Yeah.
Because party ball and shit. We walking through and everything is all good. And this girl looking at me and I'm looking at the girl and she tall and bigger. You know what I mean? Like, ooh, you a big bitch. And she went, thank you. I like that energy.
Yes. Yeah, yeah.
It's like, ooh, thank you. I'm like, okay. She knew exactly what I meant.
Yeah.
Ooh.
My only thing that offends me is when big women expect me to pick them up in bed. Bitch, I got a no regular back. I'm not. What do you think this is? This is not. I'll never forget that conversation. This girl, I said, what are you into? She's like, I like getting picked up. Word. I did not even entertain it, did not attempt it. I was like, what do you think this is? First off, here's the thing about that position. Unless that dude's way larger than you and like way stronger, you guys are going to do that for like 30 to 40 seconds. It's like when girls say, oh, I'll squat on your dick for like 10 seconds.
You do
five pumps and you get back down. How many times, guys, you've been there, the girl gets on top, she does the whole third world squat. And I was like, oh, this is nice. And like, by the time you even get into it, she's already done.
You got to support her.
Even if you support. Even if you support, it's not.
Training day.
What?
My nigga. You just got to train. This is what it is.
Yeah, they don't last long.
More often than not, I find that like my social battery sort of like runs out faster than most people. But I still like to go out and like be with people, be around people, spend time with people.
I feel like everybody nowadays loves to describe themselves as an introvert.
Yes.
Everyone.
Well, it's like everybody had ADD. It's like your faces. Yeah. Everybody has ADD.
Well, everyone wants to be a nerd.
Everybody's a nerd. No, you got glasses. You're not a nerd. Your vision is just fucked up. You're not a nerd. It's not the glasses. Calm down.
But everybody wants that currency.
Oh, I'm a nerd. No.
I'm an introvert. Like I like to be by myself.
You're not an introvert. You're a piece of shit. Nobody likes you. That's why you're alone.
That was aggressive. That was aggressive.
Yes.
I'm mad at it. You hard piece of shit.
If you had a deal breaker in terms of love languages, what love language are you not looking for?
I think definitely like receiving gifts and then anything around the idea of like materialism, right? Because I feel like it says a lot about a person and what exactly they value. Getting gifts and receiving gifts and giving gifts is like what they're striving for in life. I think this says a lot.
I like quality time. I feel like that one's like
it's pretty fucking generic. So what do you like? I like shitty time. You know, if you could be nagging all the fucking time, you know, we go to a restaurant, you're a piece of shit, you're a douchebag to the waitress. That I crave that. That's my shit. Yeah. Like, for example, we watching Netflix, you punch me in the face, damn. That's amazing.
Okay.
That'd be dope.
My suspicion is when they say quality time, they just mean like when we're together, the person puts their phone away, they're really present, they're really attentive, they're really there. But you know, I imagine there's probably some people who don't need to spend time together, but as long as there's gifts or the person like takes care of the home.
Oh, sugar babies. Yes. Yes, yes, of course.
All right.
I don't know why I'm super
kidding. That's okay. I'm not mad at it.
No.
Go in.
Oh, yeah, sugar babies. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that exists. That's nice, you know? Yeah, of course. Mm-hmm. That's typical. People that are well.
A love language I like to give to partners, you know, words of affirmation. Words can hold a lot of weight sometimes, and people...
I hate that shit.
What?
You're so amazing. I hate this shit.
Thanks, please move on.
Yeah! I hate that shit.
Yeah.
One day, I made food, someone was like, oh, this food's really delicious. I'm like, then eat, bitch.
There's a difference between yo, the food is really dope, man. Hold on. There's a difference between, this food is really dope. She, all right, cool, thing, no problem, man. I got you. Then, I just want to take this moment to thank you and to say to you how grateful I, shut the fuck up.
Here's my thing.
I just want to take this moment to just put you on notice that I really enjoyed all the time that you put to make this wonderful, wonderful, such wonderful dishes on display for us today. It's, what is this? The president's inaugural party is like, yeah, that's what I have a problem with. Something, yeah. But if motherfuckers do it, I let them do it. But I'm like, yeah, thank you.
You get one pass and then move on.
I got some of my friends that are like that.
You but get they one know, pass.
It's like, I know.
And then move on.
They don't
Either you're a it. Wonderful person. Thank you. I appreciate that. No, I don't think. Oh, no, bitch.
No,
you
no.
said it.
Now we squirt.
I accepted it. Move on.
I done took it.
I didn't say nothing. I accepted it. I didn't give you no faces. Now
no,
you want to.
No, because you, really, like, nah. You really have to understand how much I understand. I'm appreciative. No, but you don't get it. It's like, yes, I do. Maybe,
yeah, you know what it maybe, feels like?
Yes,
you
I
know
do.
What it feels like?
I do.
It feels like somebody's trying to force their shit on me.
I know.
Merci. But I want to. Oh my days, bro! That shit really irks the shit.
It's little
of
to this shit. Like if you, I really just want to say I really appreciate you. Yeah. Hey, no problem, man. It's about it. Yeah. All right. Thank you.
Yeah.
Cool. We
like,
good.
Here's my thing. And I think maybe this is just good. Me mentally. I feel like oftentimes words for me personally are pretty cheap. I think if you want to show appreciation for something, there's so many actions you can take generally that are far more endearing. For example, if I make a nice meal, you're enjoying it? Hey, I really enjoyed the meal. Cool. When we're having the meal, actually eat the food. Go through it. If you're saying you really like it, eat the food. Be present while we're having the meal. Don't be on your phone the whole time. Converse with me. Right? That shows me that you're actually appreciative of the experience itself. Right? You just give me cheap words. I'm like, I don't really care.
The thing is
this. That's me. That's me. And I also say this. I've had partners who needed those words of affirmation. So I did what I could so they could get what they needed. Wow. But again, if that's what you need, I'm going to do it for you. But I don't like that shit. The same way I hate gifts.
I know. The other day, I brought him a little box. I just said, hey, I got a gift for you. This motherfucker was so uncomfortable. And that was not really a gift. It was an inside joke we had about some fucking shit, some other video that we did. I brought him, where the bitch at? You let
crystal ball?
Yay! I brought your box. Like, oh, what is this? Here's a gift. And then you was so uneasy. It's like, this nigga, that nigga, calm down. This a joke. Fuck.
Remember that one time when you brought me a box from a fan who gave us a gift?
Nigga.
What'd I tell you?
Yo, you went like Quebec City.
What'd I do?
Shut down. You shut that shit down.
Yeah. Australia lockdown.
And
I didn't accept it.
And you know what the thing
I didn't
is?
Accept it.
I opened it.
You opened it. What was it?
You would have hated it.
Yeah.
You would have hated it.
I don't know what it was. Don't tell me. Actually, I don't want to know. But
I was not about to because I know.
Yeah. No.
Yeah, if you're sending us things and everything and stuff with the PO box, I'm the one that's opening it up.
I'm not touching anything. I don't even want to know what it is. Man, listen to 19-year-olds talk about what to look for in dating is just absolute nonsense.
Because, that was my comment from before.
Yeah, because what you like at 19 is nothing going to look like what you like at 28. So my advice to anybody who's out there dating, take anything you can get and just try things.
Yup.
You know what I mean? There's things I liked today that I didn't know I liked until I met someone who did them. And I was like, I appreciate that in a partner. So that'd be my advice to all the young folks out there who are like, I need a partner that does this. Trust me. I know ladies who are in their like mid-30s who are still thinking like, yo, I didn't know I wanted this in a partner. Or people after a divorce of 20 years, you know, realize like what they need in a partner is completely different than what they had before.
Yep.
So just be mindful of that, be open. But otherwise, good for the young man. I thought he did pretty well and he was likable and so was the people.
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah, it was a good Jubilee video. Anyways, let us know what you guys think. Is my love language acts of service?
That's you, nigga.
We'll find out. Let us know in the comments below.